this is a practice. You can use the source code from this one. This one, and to practice how to let the figure to be this one. And this is use the explorer parameter. And the second question is draw the function and with the 500 point. And you can refer to the first example. First example, this one. And this is for our practice. 好，那我们可以花十分钟来做个练习。第一个是怎么把这张图变成这个样子。那这个就是有提到说，我们刚刚在这个范例里面，最后一个范例里面，它的这个跟圆心的距离，可以用这边的程式来稍微修改。然后第二个问题是，请画一个函数，然后它的S 坐标是介于这里10到20之间，然后有500个点。好，那这个部分就可以参考我们的第一个案例，然后来做修改。这边好，那这边就是先让同学先稍微练习一下，那等等我们再看他的参考答案。 跟 let me see 的reference answer， 好，那我们来看看一下它的参考解答。Because the question one is about the export, because you can compare this figure and this figure, you can see the differences here and here. So this is about the export. So we only modify the number in for the day 3 and the day 5. Day 3 and the day 5, so we will get the figure like this one. And this is the first question. We can change and modify the export and to make the day 3 and the day 5 far from the circle hut. 好，那第一个问题呢，它就是原本这一张图变成这样，那它唯一的差别就是它跟圆心的距离。那刚好提到跟圆心的距离有关的，就是在这个 export 的部分，所以我们只要改第三天跟第五天的值，它就可以达到这样的一个状况。Okay, and the second question is draw the function.And this is the function, and the x is between minus 10 and 20, and with 500 point. So we reference to the first example. You can see this is our x. So we just change here minus 10 and 10 to the minus 10 to 20 and 500. So we can modify here. This is our first step. And the second step is modify the y function. Here is the sign. So we want to we need to modify the sign to this function. Okay. And after this thought, or based on this thought, we can draw our function like this one. This one. First, we multiply the x minus 10 and 20 and to 500, and y is to this function, x plus x and plus x. Then this means the exponential 3.And the phi multiple the x exponential 2 and minus 9. And then we can plot the x and y like this one. Or you can use another way to complete this one. The way is you use a defined function like you give him a x, and then it will return the value of the question need. And then you can draw like this one. This y is the function like this one, and then we plot x and y. 好，那第二题的部分呢，它就是要我们来画一个 s 介于负十跟二十中间，然后有500个点，然后y 的函数是这个样子，那这个我们就可以用第一个的例子来做修改，也就是说，原本第一个例子是长这个样子，我们只要把 s 的坐标从负十十改成负十二十，然后100个点改成500个点，然后再来第二个是 y 的函数不一样，在第一个例子 y 的函数是 sin， 那我们就把这个改成是题目所要的。那所以呢，我们就可以把它改成是像这个样子 ，s 是负十到二十之间500个点，然后 y 就是 s 的三次方加5乘以 s 的二次方减9， 那我们就可以把 x 跟 y 放进来，就可以得到这条线。那另外一种的写法呢，它是用到自定义函数，那你就可以看到说，你可以自定一个函数，所以当 x 传过来，我就会传这样的一个结果给它，一样是 x 三次方加五乘平方减九。好，那你这样子就可以把 y 的值透过自定义函数把它算出来，然后最后再把 x 跟 y 放进去，就会得到这个。Okay. And I will upload this file to Teams and Moodle. 好，那我之后会把这个档案把它放到我们的 Teams 跟 Moodle 上。Okay. And then we see the pandas. And pandas is the powerful library or powerful package. And this is can deal with the lot of data, especially for the data has many columns or many rows. For example, you can use the pandas to deal with the Titanic file. For this one, this is the Titanic file. If you copy this link, and you can see the Titanic file will like this one. This is a lot of data here. Many rows and many columns, and each column has their titles here. Okay. And before we deal with the Titanic file, like this one, and we need to know how to use the pandas and how many common useful commands are in pandas. Okay. 好，那pandas 呢，它是一个可以处理很大量资料的一个很常用的一个套件。那尤其是说，假如你的资料会很像 Excel 那样子，有很多栏、很多列的话，它就更适合来做用 pandas 来做一些处理。那像是说，像蛮有名的铁达尼号的档案呢，像这种就很适合用 pandas 来做一些相关的处理。那我们把这个中间的连结把它复制下来贴到我们的浏览器上，你就可以看到这个铁达尼号它拥有很多的资料，然后它有很多的列啊，很多的栏，那每个栏上面还有个特别的标题，那我们要怎么来处理它？这就是我们要先了解 pandas 它有哪些常用的指令可以拿来做处理。Okay. And here we will use two files, pandas 1 and pandas 2 to introduce pandas. And if you want to know more about pandas, you can use the search engine to search pandas. And there is aofficial website of pandas, and you can look more details in that official website. 好，那我们会先利用两个档案来做介绍，一个叫做 pandas 1，一个叫 pandas 2，然后来先做一个简单的 pandas 套件的介绍。那假如同学想要更深入了解 pandas， 那你可以在搜寻引擎上找 pandas， 然后它会有它的官方网站，那可以从官方网站里头会得知更多的讯息在里面。And there are two types in pandas, and one is called series, and this is for the one-dimensional array.And the second one is called the data frame. Sorry, here data frame, and this is for two-dimensional arrays. And data frame is more useful than the series, and because our data are in data frame type or there are two dimensional types, array types. But the series is the basic foundation or basic component for the data frame. So we will introduce series first. 好，那在 Pandas 里头呢，它可以说它是有两种的资料形态，一种就称为是 series， 就是在这边看到这个 series， 那它是给一维的资料所使用，也就是一列或一栏来做使用。那另外一种的资料呢，它就叫 data frame， 它就是给二维来做使用。那在使用上，二维的 data frame 它比一维的 series 还要更常做使用，这是因为我们之后处理的资料，或者是我们常看到的资料，它不太可能就只有一列或一栏的，它一定都是有很多列、很多栏，所以绝大部分的资料它都是二维的。好，那为什么我们还是要去介绍一维的呢？这是因为一维它是二维的基础，因为两个一维它就可以把它组合成是二维，所以我们要稍微了解一下一维的 series。Okay. And when we use pandas, we need to import pandas, and you can use pd for its short name. So we will use import pandas as pd. And this one is to create a series to show the data. And we can use s for thevariable, and this is the, to create a series data. You can use pd.series, and this is the data, and data equals to your data. Like this, in this example, we use the range 1 and 5, and then we will generate the data from 1, 2, 3, 4, and because 5 is not included in our data, andWe also can name the index. We can use an index equal to list. So you can see the index will named from A to D. And if you don't write this parameter, the index will use default, like the 0 to 4. And then we see the data type of thisseries. This is a pandas called series data type, and we can use the value to get the data value and the index to get the index value, like this one. We use s the value. We can see the value of data is 4 here because we use a range, and index is a b c d because wenamed the index here. And the whole series, you can use this to print. You can see this is the index A, B, C, D. And this is the data value here. So this is the index, this is the value. And if you don't write this scene, the A, B, C, D will change to 0, 1, 2, 3. This is the default.Index value by Python. 好，那首先呢，我们第一个案例是怎么去产生一个 series 的资料。那 series 的资料它的产生就是 pd.series 后面就接你的资料跟你的索引值。那资料的接法就是你写 data 等于你它的资料。那像我们这个案例是给它零一二三四，那5它不包含在里面，所以是1234。那我们的 index 可以写它是一个 ABCD 的索引值。那在这一行，假如这个我们没有写的话， Pandas 或者说 Python 它就会用它预设的值，它的索引值就从0开始就会变成0123。所以在 Pandas 里面，它给我们的可以自己命名索引值的一个能力。 好，那我把它印出来的话，你可以看到这个创建出来的 series， 它的 type 就是 pandas 点 core 点 series 的这个格式，然后它的资料的值你可以用 s 点 value 来取得，所以你看到它是1234。那同样的，我们也可以用点 index 的方式来取得它的索引值，你看到它这是索引值是 a b c d。好，那我们这个 series 把它印出来的话，你会看到像是这样的形态。那它不是二维，它是一维，主要是1234才是它的真正的资料的值，然后 a b c d 是它的索引值，所以索引值并不是一个维度，它只是代表在这个位置上它存的是一，在这个位置上存在的是二。那刚好提到，假如我们 index 没写的话，它这边就是用它的预设值0123来做它的索引值。And we want to access one value of data or a range of value of data. We can use the list we like s and use the index of a because our index is a b c d. So we can use s and a. So we can get the value of this here s of a, so we can get one here. And this is similar to the list. And next we want to get a range like this one from b to d, so we can get 2, 3, 4 here. And if we want to get a multiple value, and this is not a range, so we can use the like this one. A, D, C, like this. We want to get the index of A, index of D, D, and index of C here, and we can get the 1, 4, 3 here. And remember that if this is a range, you can use this simple between the star value to end value, and if you use another range, you need to type each index value and you need to give in the simple here. 好，那它的取值的方式呢，它就跟我们在之前 list 所学到的很像，就是你把你要取的值的索引值给它，它就可以得到它相对应的资料的值，像说 s 的，然后写 a 啊，就看到这 index a 它所对应的是一，所以它就会吐出一。这是针对一个的时候可以这样取。那假如你是针对多个的时候，那假如它是一个范围的，你就可以写 d 到 d，就跟我们之前取范围一样，然后中间用冒号隔开，它就会取到b 到 d 的值，就是 b 到 d 的值就会取出来。好，那假如说你是想多个，但它不是一个范围的话，那你就会需要用逗点的方式把它隔开来，隔开来。然后记得，当你不是一个范围的时候，你就要自己再加一个中括号，让它变成它是一个 list 的形式才能取到。所以像在这里，我是分别先取 a，再取 d，再取 c 的值，所以 a d c 那就会得到这样子的一个结果。And then we can use rename to rename our index or value in our series. And also, we can use rename in data frame. And the rename way is that if you have the series and you can use this variable dot rename, and then if we want to rename the A to AA, so we can use like the dictionary, like A, this is the old index value, and this is the new index value, like this one, like the dictionary. And then here is the very important parameter. In pandas, the default for the impress is false. That means in this command, whether you write this parameter or not, this is the result is the same. Okay. And this means if the impress is false, that means the pandas will create another series to store your new change. And this new series is different from the old series. And I mean that this is the old series. We use the S variable to store this one. And we change this name from A to AA. Okay. And if we say the impress is false or we don't write this one, the pandas will automatically find the memory and use the new memory to store the new change like this one. And this one D here, you can see that print S, you can see S is A B C D 1 2 3 4, and the D we can see that index value is changed, and the D is another series, and that means S and D are two different series, and the original one's value is still like doesn't change and doesn't be modified. And the other way, other hand, if we change impress is true, and then the original data will be modified and there is no new series or new memory here for D. We can see that this is the equal the same. This is rename A, this is rename A and B. And then we can see that S, the original data is modified, and the D, the system say there is no D here because we say the impress is true, and this will directly modify the original data S, and didn't create new series and didn't use the memory to store the new series. That means there is no new data here. 好，那在使用这个 series 或 data frame 的时候，我们可以用 rename 的方式来改变它里面的值。像说，在这个范例里面，我去想改它的索引值，然后从原本的 A B C D 改成是 A 变成 AA。好，那我们这样就可以看到，它可以用 rename， 然后 A 旧的名称变成新的名称。那它的写法就跟字典那样子很像，就是我们字典也是用大括弧，然后前面有一个值，后面有个值。那在这边，它就是用这样的方式来改索引值的名字。好，那后面的这个参数呢，它是一个很重要的参数，以后在 data frame 的时候，它也会很常来做使用。那 impress 它在 pandas 的预设值它是 false。那所以换句话说，就是你有写这一行或没写这一行，它都是对结果不会影响，因为它的预设值就是 false。 那它的作用是做什么？它的作用呢，就是需不需要改到原来真正原来的资料。假如你没设，或者是你设成 false， 就是它不要改到原本的资料，然后它会用新的记忆体，或者说是从另外一块记忆体来存被改过后的资料。就像我们这个案例来看，就是 S 原本的资料它是长这个样子，就是 ABCD1234。 那经过改过之后，我们直觉应该会说 S 应该会变成 AA 然后 BCD。 但是因为我们这边的 值，他是说我们不要改到原始资料，所以在改过之后，他这个被改过的资料呢，他就会利用一个新的记忆体，然后来存放。所以你看这边讲，我们设另外一个变数 d 的话，你就看到 s 它还是原来的资料，它没有被改到。然后 d 它会利用新的记忆体的空间来存这个 d， 你就看到后面的结果是我们改过的结果，就变成 a 就变成 aa， 好，所以它就会产生出两个 series， 然后这两个是完全不一样的。那相反的，假如我们把 in place 改成 true 的话，它就意思就表示说，哎，我要直接去改我的原始的资料啊，所以你就看到 s 经过这样的一个重新命名之后，然后它后面又设成是我要直接去改这原始资料，你就看到 s 它的值就变成 aa bb 1234。你就看到原始的 S 就被改掉了。那因为我已经要改了原始的值，我就不用再有新的一个记忆体空间来存放这个被改过的值，所以你就看到 D 这边它就不会出现， D 就没有了，就没有这个 D 存在。换句话说， place 有设跟没设它的结果差异很大。当你把它设成 true 的时候，它就直接改原本的资料，原本的资料，然后它不会产生新的资料出来。那假如你是设成 false 的话，它就是不会动到原本的资料，但它会另外产生新的资料，然后用新的记忆空间、记忆体空间把它存起来。Okay. And this one is another example to show the different subset. This is S1 equal to S from index of 1 to the end, and the other is from the begin to the minus 1. Okay. And the print is different in these two examples. This example is to see the F in here, in this print. You can see the content of this print is data of S1 and the data of S2. And for this example, we can see in the content of print, this is more have the F here. And the results are different. In this one, the print will think this is the content to print. So you can see a data of S1 here, and then enter, and then S1 here, and then enter, and then data of S2 and S2. And this is print this line. And if you have F, it will think this is to print the value of S1 and value of S2. So you can see the result is data of S1. Data of S1 is the same, but for the value of S1 is different. S1, this is the string, but this one is the data of this one, S1. And then data of S2 is similar. This is the data of S2.And this is the string here. 好，那在后面的接下来的这两个案例呢，它又是来跟我们说，假如我们想要去印出 series 里面的资料的时候，我们不能只有打 print， 然后直接接 S1， 因为它这样子会认为你这个是字串，它就直接印出来，你就可以看到它这边就会认为是 data of S1 冒号，然后断行，然后直接印出 S1， 它会以为这样子是一个字串。但是我们的用意呢，并不是要印出 S1 这样的一个字串，我们是希望能印出 S1 的值。那这时候我们就要用一个 F 来 表示，这样他才会知道说这边是自串，然后到 S1 的时候，它是要印出它里头的内容，然后在后面是一样的。好，所以你就看到这两个最后的结果就会不同。第一个结果是它把 S1 当成自串就直接印出来，那第二个是它印到 S1 之后，这边然后冒号要接 S1， 它会知道说，哎，我要去 S1 去找它的值，把它印出来 S1 的值。那 S1 的值呢，就是S 上面这个 S 从 index 是一，然后一直到最后，所以就是 BCD 到最后，然后 S2 就是相反，它就是这样子印出来。好，所以这是两个的差别，差别就差在有没有这个 F。你就看到这上面是把它当成自串印，下面是把它的内容印出来。And if we have a lot ofitem in our series, we can use the unique to show our how many type of item. For example, this is the A, B, and C, D, and B, A, B, A, B, B, and B, B, C. There are seven type of item here. The first one is A, second B.Third C, fourth D, and this is the same to the B. So this is 4 and 5, fifth is AB, sixth is AAB, and seventh is BBC. So we can use S dot unique to show the number of type of this item. Okay. And you can use S dot unique to show the my god, sorry. I restart all. Okay, if you use the unique, it will show the data here, A, B, C, D, and only show the one times for each type of data, and if you use the unique, it will show the number of the data type. I think I put one here. Okay. 好，那再接下来呢，我可以根据它的资料呢有没有重复来看它总共有几个资料，像是假如我们用 unique 的话，它就会把重复的地方把它拿掉，只就说哎，我这里面它总共有多少种不同的物件在里头。那假如我们只是要算它的个数的话，就是在前面再加个 n， 它会跟你说总共有七种不一样的A, B, C, D, A, B, A, B 跟 B, B, C， 他就会跟你说在这边会有七种。Okay. And pandas have some function from MemparLab, so we can use the plot here to draw the feature like this one. We have a series here, and we have want to show the value of each item and sort by the index, and we want to plot here. So we can first we can use this S value count. And maybe I disappear it and I separate it like this one. And in example, we have a series here, and then we want to count the value, and then we want to sort them, and then show their feature like this one. So first step, we can use this one. We can count count this value like this one. B has 4B, 1, 2, 3, 4, and have 2C, 2A, 2-1. And then we sort them by index, because this is sort by value, and we want to sort by index A, B, C, D. So here, and the third is to make them to be the fixture, and we can let the point plot here. Okay. And these three steps, you can combine them by the point here. That means in this command, we first count the value like this one, and then sort the data by index will like this one, and then we plot them to the fixture like this one. Or you can see this can be separated by the three comment, like the values count to the variable and the variable to sort, and then plot like this one. Okay. 好，那我们这个下面的例子呢，是说，假如我们有这样的一串的资料，那我想要去计算它们的个数有几个，然后再透过它们的索引子来排序，然后最后把它画成图，那可以怎么做？那这样的做法呢，我们可以一步一步来，像说，我先去计算它的个数，然后再排序，然后再画图，最后会得到这样一张图。那我们也可以把它用点的方式把它连接在一起，就像是三个指令合在一起，计算个数、排序跟画图，它就会像这样。那上面只是把它拆解成一个一个步骤给大家看，像这个，计算个数，然后排序，然后再画图。Okay. And this is another example. You sort first, and then you count value and plot here. And this is another example. We rename this one, and we can use the describe to get the common used result here, like the count, average, standard, and the mini, maxima value, and so on. Okay. And this is another example by the similar to the above example. Okay. And this is the series here. 好，那后面的部分呢，它就事实上就是把前面的这几块再做一些练习。那我们可以看到，像说我可以把它的顺序调换，像是我先排它的索引值，再去算它的个数，然后再画图。但你会发现，当我们先排序索引值，再算个数的时候，这个个数它的排序又变成是依照大小，所以就会前面就等于是白做工。所以当我们在放顺序的时候，要稍微想一下哪个要放前，哪个放后，免得有的指令放进去是等于白放的。好，那后面的地方，它就是把前面的案例再拿来做练习的部分。好，那有时候我们也可以用这个 describe 来秀出他们常看到的一些数值，像是有多少个数，它的平均值、标准差、最大最小值等等的部分。然后最后一个又是另外一个案例，那这个跟前面一样，所以我们就略过给同学们看。Okay. Okay. And this is the series about the pandas. And then next week we don't have class because you need to prepare your midterm project. And for the November 16th,next week we don't have class, and November 16 is the midterm project presentation, and every group needs to present your midterm project, and you can use English or use Chinese, and if you are a student in HR University. Okay. And then November 23, we will continue our pandas.Here, data frame and the Titanic example. 好，那 到这边，今天是我们的Series Pandas 的 Series 的介绍。那下个礼拜我们就给大家做期中报告的准备，所以我们就没有课程在安排在里头。然后11月16号是期中报告，那再来11月23号才会再回到我们的课程，也就是会再介绍 Data Frame 跟铁达尼号的案例，然后还有之后的后续的部分。 Okay, and this is our class today, and see you November 16. 好，那这是我们今天的课程，那我们下一次见面会是在11月16号的时候。 OK, 拜拜。拜拜。可以。